You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Have to work though, sort of the dark side, if you will. We've got to spend time in the shadows and in the intelligence world. A lot of what needs to be done here will have to be done quietly, without any discussion, using sources and methods that are available to our intelligence agencies, if we're going to be successful. That's the world these folks operate in, and so it's going to be vital for us to use any means at our disposal, basically, to achieve our objective.
And now Al-Qaeda is bigger than it's ever been, and it's renamed ISIS, and our own government funded it, and William Binney was beginning to get into 9/11, and I've had Colonel Schaefer on, I've had Sybil Edmonds on, I've had the translators, the colonels, I've had so many angles of this, covering classified and unclassified information and leaked information that we know they knew about 9/11 and bare minimum stood down. Six of the 10 commissioners have said that. William Binney, without giving out any classified information, obviously, what can you tell us about 9/11?
Well, it's more like after we left NSA because of the domestic spying way. Tom Drake, who was still there working, ran a program we were developing to on the entire database in NSA, and he found all the data that was necessary to stop 9/11 in their databases prior to 9/11, which simply meant, very simply put, that they could easily have stopped 9/11 if they were doing smart things. But what was driving them at the time? Well, it was a matter of getting more and more money and building a bigger budget, and that's really what their emphasis was on. So they didn't they weren't trying to do smart things. They were trying to do things that would build their empire. And that to me is why I keep saying every time I give a talk anywhere, I keep saying they traded the security of the people of the United States and of the world for money.
And I guess when you make multi-billion dollar purchases from big tech firms for their supercomputers and fiber optic and cables, and you end up getting nice president jobs a few years later with that revolving door, it just turns into a giant boondoggle.
Yeah, that's that incestuous relationship that exists between government officials and private industry. Yeah, that close relationship building between them so that they can move from one senior executive job in government to a senior executive job in industry.
What do you think about moves to cut off electricity and the water supply in Utah to the data center?
Well, I mean, they could certainly try to do that, but I would think that they would call up the National Guard, nationalize things, and go in and make sure that they could continue to keep the power going. To me, the more important way to attack this problem is to go after them legally by the voting and by getting rid of them and firing their worthless personages from Congress.
Well, would think that there would be rolling this back with all the lies coming out and that they were deceptive and they're using it against Congress. But instead, like you said, they're just getting the courts lined up to legalize it.
Right, and they're feeling more confident because some of the judges are getting behind them and backing it.
And I think that's through fear as well.
Right. You never know what kind of blackmail they have on those judges because of the collection of data they've got.
The word is that Justice Roberts was being blackmailed on the Obamacare situation.
Yeah, well, that could be. I mean, after all, he did change he changed it from a penalty to a tax, and that's changing the law. And he should have thrown that back to Congress for the Congress to fix that, not the court.
Yeah, the fix is in.
Yeah.
Wow. Final segment with William Binney. A ton of Twitter questions and your calls. Michael, Peter, Shane, Anthony, Jay. Your call straight ahead for William Binney. You can find out his writings and more at exposedfacts.org or whistleblower.org. Stay with us.
As the year is coming to a close, we all pause to reflect on what's happened in the past year. We take a step back and thank God for what we have. I'm David Hall, founder of Diamond Gusset Jeans. At Diamond Gusset, we are celebrating the brush fires of liberty that are spreading across this great nation. Another thing we are celebrating is you. Without the valued listeners of Alex Jones and our loyal customers, we wouldn't be here today. We offer a wonderful online shopping experience. If you receive a pair that doesn't fit, send them back and we'll exchange them at no cost to you. Beat the shopping rush by visiting us at gusset.com and join our email newsletter to receive some great holiday discounts. And paying no attention to political correctness, Diamond Gusset wants to wish you all a Merry Christmas. Thanks for believing in our dream, the original 100% American-made Diamond Gusset jean.
When I first got online and I seen the price of the X2 and the DNA Force, I was a little hesitant, but I pulled the trigger on it. It has changed my life. I've been taking it for about 24 days now, counting the weight, staying in shape.
InfoWarsLife.com. You've heard the callers of the show.
Several months back, I started taking your Nathan Iodine and your Super Meal. Prior to this, I was barely walking. Now I'm able to function as a human again.
Whether it's Survival Shield, Nathan Iodine, or DNA Force, Super Male Vitality, Super Female Vitality, Lung Cleanse, Fluoride Shield, Oxy Powder. I believe that all of these products will blow you away like they've done the thousands of other customers that have visited InfoWarsLife.com.
That's too. Just amazing what it's able to do to actually detox the body. It's great stuff.
If I'm going to promote something, it's got to be something I personally use and that I believe in. Check out InfoWarsLife.com today and the entire line of groundbreaking, cutting-edge, hardcore products. The experts are clear. Sunlight, purified water, healthy non-GMO food, and having a good attitude is essential to a healthy immune system. But I go further with Super Nascent Iodine X2 from InfoWarsLife.com. 50% stronger than our original and revolutionary Nascent Iodine formula, coming from a deep earth crystal source that no other supplier has. Most other forms of iodine come from seaweed in areas plagued by Fukushima and other contaminants. Not our iodine. It comes from over 200 million year old crystal salt deposits and is tested and proven to be completely pure. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. See the informational videos, read the information they're compiled, and for a limited time, when you use promo code NOW at checkout, you get an additional 5% off the entire family of InfoWarsLife.com products. Secure your Survival Shield X2 today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
It's our final segment with top NSA whistleblower William Binney. They tried to charge him, the SWAT team raided him, you name it, when he was just trying to quietly, legally work through the federal government and Congress to try to stop the illegal spying. They instead tried to throw him in prison for it, and many others. It's a testament that we've still got some justice in the court systems, but not much, that he and others have escaped prison. Others haven't. They've been trying to put journalists in jail that talked to somebody at the Defense Department at a press conference about North Korea. And they say, well, we don't want you getting the opinion that we don't think, or we do think, they have nukes. We're going to arrest you. I mean, this is really a major power grab. And who would want to do this to our country? Who would want to do this to our children? Who really wants to do this? They are using the NSA and other agencies to target the general public. It's a weird feeling when I went to cover Bilderberg and they had plainclothes Marines threatening us, flipping us off, pulling dirty tricks on us. And it later came out and was confirmed that their diplomatic security corps was there. They saw us as the enemy. They had been trained. The Marines, officers all, some of them like 45 years old, to harass peaceful journalists that they knew were peaceful. This is the government we built and paid for being turned against us, and the press is being persecuted. It's clear where this is going. We're not troublemakers up here just saying, oh, come on. It's all been proven. William Benny, before we take some final calls, what do you think hurts the NSA most? Because the fact that they lied and denied they were spying on citizens in non-terror-related cases, and the fact that it's now come out, I mean, is that the biggest blow to the NSA? And where do you think this fight's going?
Actually, I don't think in the long run, I don't think it's been a blow to them. I think they got it to the point where they simply don't care what the public thinks. It's the arrogance of power.
Hubris.
Yeah, and so I don't think they really care. I mean, the one thing that could really hurt them is cutting their financial money, cutting the budget that they have. That is the thing that would hurt them. That's why they got so nervous about Representatives Amash and Conyers and their coalition group to unfund NSA last July. I mean, I don't think I told you this on the programs before, but I was scheduled to brief that coalition prior to them voting on unfunding NSA. And when they posted that on the congressional record that I was coming down there to testify to them, what happened was the President Obama called a meeting of all the members of the House, all the House Democratic members at the same time. So that basically killed that meeting. And so that was delayed, but we never rescheduled. So they never got the, and then they had the vote on it, and they lost the vote because of lobbying by the president and also General Alexander, heavy lobbying to try to stop it. They lost by 12 votes. But that was pretty good from a first cut. I mean, the basic motivation that started all this was the fact that they began to realize that they weren't being told the truth by the intelligence committees or by the agencies or by the White House, so that they were being lied to all along.
Because it's illegal.
Yes.
So simple. Right. Let's talk to Michael in Ohio. You're on the air.
Hi, I think there might have been a mistake there. I'm actually calling from FEMA Region 5, but I just kind of wanted to talk to Mr. Benny about what he thought about the racial divide that they're bringing up to kind of distract us from what's going on with the NSA.
That's a great point. We're all having our rights to privacy taken, and meanwhile, you'd think the only issue in the world is race. William Benny?
It's a standard thing that a dictator does when you are having internal problems in your country, you create an external threat. So in this case, what they're doing is creating other threats or other conflicts to deflect interest and focus away from core issues that are fundamental to everything we do.
Absolutely right about that. Anything else, Michael?
Yeah, I think it's funny that the issues like Ebola and ISIS have also been kind of swept under the rug, and no one wants to focus on that, but they sure want to focus on the race issue of what they want us to focus on.
Thank you, Michael. Peter in Washington, you're on the air.
Yes, I have a question. I know it's about before your time, but what do you think of Alan Dulles? Do you know anything about or heard anything about him with regard to how whether he was not so bad or really bad and so forth?
No, I didn't know anything about him or his when he was in office. I didn't. I wasn't aware of what he was doing. So.
All right, Peter. Appreciate your call.
And I never heard anything since then. So.
Let's talk to Anthony in Florida. You're on the air.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
I got a question for Mr. Benny. Has it been possible, like for a long time, that the NSA has the capability and technology to actually watch, for example, somebody walking down in a street, or, you know, like
Sir, let me tell you, since you're hesitating, They have satellites with infrared, other things can track people in real time. They're tied into a lot of the cameras nationwide that have face scanning software on them. That's all admitted. They're getting ready to go to tax by the mile using these systems. What is your specific question?
NSA for a long time has it had the capability to actually see people even before the Yes,
and for decades, yeah.